Welcome back. We here on the Ingram Angle have been hearing that there might soon be a major announcement about the Hillary Clinton email investigation on Capitol Hill. Joining us now from Tallahassee, Florida, is someone who might have a thing or two to do with that, Congressman Matt Gaetz, a Republican from Florida. Congressman, you can't tease us and give us nothing here tonight. Okay, there's something going on. My ears have been, you know, filled up with all sorts of whispers all day today about something involving a special designation for the Hillary Clinton email investigation over at the FBI, and that is raising questions. What can you tell us tonight? And if you say you can't talk about it, we're going to have to go talk about David Cassidy again for another segment. Go ahead.
Well, we absolutely can talk about it, Laura. I am immediately calling for an investigation into the special treatment that the FBI gave Hillary Clinton, and particularly in this email scandal. In late October, right before the election, emails were sent by now the deputy director of the FBI, Andrew McCabe, where McCabe said that the Hillary investigation would be given special status, that it would not go through the normal investigative procedures that would typically append to this type of an investigation. He told others at the FBI that there would be a small team at headquarters that would make the decisions and conduct the investigation, walling off others who might have discovered information or brought additional facts to light. Link this to the information we have about James Comey drafting the exoneration statement of Hillary Clinton before she was even interviewed, before other key witnesses were interviewed. So now we have absolute proof of what you've been saying for a long time, Laura, and that's that Hillary Clinton was treated differently than any other American would be treated. And as a member of the Judiciary Committee, I want answers from the FBI about how we can stop this type of special treatment for politicians in the future.
Now, we've been talking about the special treatment that politicians get when it comes to issues of harassment, other types of discrimination, with that slush fund on Capitol Hill, $17 million paid out to victims, all confidential. And that's just an absolute outrage. But in this case, we're talking about the former Secretary of State. She's running for president. As a white-hot spotlight on her and on this question of her emails, the ones that were destroyed, the intent to set up that private server. When something is designated as special investigation, one could hear that and say there's going to be more scrutiny placed on the subject. But you're saying when it's special, it means skirting normal channels? Is that what you can confirm to us tonight?
Well, Laura, we have to look at all the evidence in context. Here you have Mr. McCabe telling others at the FBI that this won't be handled like other investigations, that it'll be a small team at headquarters. The reason that's so troubling is that we've learned, as a consequence of testimony before the Senate, that James Comey, leading that investigation, it drafted the exoneration statement, essentially rendered the verdict on the Hillary Clinton email scandal before even conducting the investigation. Now we've got these McCabe emails that show that others were not allowed to participate, that they were expressly excluded. Even more damning context is the fact that these emails also reveal that McCabe was dealing with his own scandal because he was involved with his wife's political campaign funded by the Clintons and their allies. And that's not the type of FBI we need. We need the type of checks and balances at the FBI where people get equal treatment under the law. We don't have that in a circumstance where you got special treatment for someone like Hillary Clinton, and then you've got an exoneration statement before you even have the investigation concluded.
Now, I think we're going to be learning a lot more about Andrew McCabe in the coming weeks. And you can't mix politics in the FBI. You're not supposed to. And so his wife is running for Virginia Senate. A lot of questions remaining about him and Comey together, and we appreciate it. Happy Thanksgiving, Congressman, and you can give us more information next week. We want all the information next week. We want all the document requests. We want all the memos to the file that Jim Comey did in the back of a sedan. We want all those. So.
Fox News national security strategist Sebastian Gorka, conservative commentator Monica Crowley, trial attorney Rebecca Rose Woodland.
Where do we start, Rebecca?
Well, I mean, there are so many people. Every day there are more. With Charlie Rose, at least he was fired today. At least he admitted he did these things. So these victims are not further victimized by the press and people who just keep insisting that all these women are lying. There can't be this many women lying. It can't be a whole group of people throughout the course of America who are lying. It's not possible. It doesn't make sense.
We are in this moment now, Sean, because for decades, this kind of horrid behavior has been covered up, excused, and accepted. And so now with the Harvey Weinstein piece in the New York Times opened the floodgate, and that's why you have now this explosion of stories. People feel empowered to come out and tell their stories. But here's the interesting thing. This kind of horrid behavior, if you look at politics, for example, goes back to JFK, Ted Kennedy, Lyndon Johnson. But in the modern
era, Ted Kennedy, who left the lion of the Senate, that left a woman in the bottom of a body of water. He went home, told nobody. There was a house across the street,
and he was so beloved. Lionized. But in the modern era, a lot of people are putting the current marker at Bill Clinton and his behavior because he was excused by the woman who was the most powerful and influential in the country, not just in his life, but Mrs. Clinton. So there's a special place in hell, Sean, for the women who have covered for this kind of behavior.
Listen to what I said about John Conyers. I don't never liked a thing that John Conyers ever said. Politically, we're on opposite sides. John Conyers says no. Others say it didn't happen. I believe Clarence Thomas was smeared at the last minute. You see, October surprise after October surprise, whether it's a DUI for George Bush or an allegation in a campaign 30 days out of an election, sometimes it's not true. What do we do? How should people act when one side says it happened and without smearing them like the Clintons did for 30 years? And take their allegations seriously, especially in the case of, is it pedophilia? We need to find out. We need to know. We need in every case to know the truth. But how do you balance that? And then I'll get to Sebastian in a minute.
Well, this is the issue now. With Conyers, we're bringing up a huge issue in Congress.
Am I right to give him the presumption of innocence?
No, absolutely not.
I'm wrong to do that?
No, you're absolutely right. I'm sorry. You're absolutely right to do it as you've done it across over the last week. I think you should.
I've done it my whole career, Rebecca.
Well, I'm saying with all these victims, we've discussed this over and over. I mean, that's what the Constitution provides. Absolutely. The problem with Congress is there's not a body that is investigating carefully, distinctively, and without some sort of, there's a whole shadow over this office of compliance that women have to go to. It's not only women, men as well, have to go to if they were harassed. And this office of compliance is shrouded in secrecy. So there might be a way for, with all of these complaints now, to restructure that and have a better place for people to go.
If we're going to have a coming to Jesus moment, mm-hmm. I think in the end, as a father, I have three sisters, Dr. Gorka, just the people that admitted these things and groping Franken with his stupid, with what he did to poor Leanne Tweeden is enough. You know, but it was conservatives that were out there on the front line saying, wow, all of these women, and there was more besides Juanita and Kathleen and Paula and Monica. There were a lot of other women involved in this too that sure. I interviewed over the years. How do you balance that? And how much damage do liberals do in terms of they want the mantle that they are the great protectors of women's rights, but yet they were involved in protecting the Clintons all those decades?
Now, that's the real question. So you've been very, very righteous in terms of giving the question of the reasonable doubt, the idea that you have to prove the case, the presumption of innocence, whether it's Judge Moore, whether it's John Conyers. But let's step back and let's talk about that bigger issue. The left as a whole has no vision and no morals. They are spiritually and politically bankrupt, Sean. Why? Because they made this all possible. Whether it was covering for Ted Kennedy, whether it was covering for Bill Clinton, they've created this mantra for 30 years. It's just sex. It's okay. It's private. Don't worry about it. This created a culture of permissiveness. As a result, the political side of the aisle that says we are for women, we support the victims, they have completely hollowed out their own moral standing. And I want to see a reckoning right now. I want to see the real feminists get out on the street. I don't care what kind of hat they're wearing, but I want them to protest because, hey, we're the right. They hate us. I get it. But they made this possible on their own side. Let's talk about Charlie Rose. Charlie Rose?
Let me ask Monica this question. You know, what convinced me is right from the get-go with the Clintons, Jennifer Flowers had tapes. They actually said, dude, you doctored the tapes. I don't know if that, you could hear it was his voice. You can hear an intimate conversation that was going on there, but they still went out, denied it. Late years later, he had to admit it.
Yeah,
and they
just,
go on singing.
Just to be clear,
but
that was a consensual relationship, though, Sean, with Jennifer Flowers.
That, that's different, different, very different, issue. Agreed, but he still lied.
Yes.
Okay, and that was part of it. And she was smeared, and she was telling the truth. That's the difference. You know, in the case of how much will science now play a role? One of the things I thought in the Roy Moore case, for example, as I talked to a 42-year expert in handwriting analysis, said you give him, he's done this 42 years. It's an art. It's a science. And he's going to be able to tell you forensically if the ink is new or old, and forensically if he can look at his handwriting at the time with that yearbook. There's their answer.
Right. And these investigations should go on because nobody should be smeared in this way if the charges are false. Problem is here, time is of the essence, right? There's another point about hypocrisy that I want to make, Sean. Over these last couple of decades, every Republican that's been embroiled in some sort of sex scandal, the left has piled on because they used to say that conservative ran as a family values candidate or a family values
Republican. So if you have
Republican,
no standards,
so they're
you're better off.
But the left is equally as hypocritical in this sense, where they position themselves as big champions of women. And yet, in their private lives, what's coming to light now is that their behavior against women has been absolutely atrocious.
Closing remarks, Dr. Gorka, we'll go to you first.
I think this is just the tip of the iceberg, Sean. I think we have to, you know, strap on our seatbelts and hold tight, because I think this is the beginning of an avalanche. And I hope it means that the left will have to clean house. No more double standards. No more playing the victim card. And
hey, they protected him through 2016. You know, the only reason that they're doing it now is because they don't need the Clintons anymore.
Correct.
Clintons can't do anything for him anymore. All right.
Correct.
Sorry, Rebecca, last word.
I think I agree with Dr. Gorka. This is the beginning of an avalanche, and I think it's a great opportunity for us to change values in this country and to change the way we treat victims and how we handle.
I totally agree.
Yeah.
And we have to be careful, though. This is dangerous territory.
And just a word of warning, this kind of behavior has no political or partisan boundaries.
Oh, you're going to have it. Oh, yeah.
So while, you know, a lot of these perpetrators and predators are on the left, look, it could be a big conservative tomorrow. So let's just
let the people of Minnesota decide?
Well, the people of Minnesota should decide, as the people of Alabama should decide on
who should decide in Franken's case with the picture. You have evidence.
I think Al Franken should resign himself.
You do, Dr. Gorka?
He should take himself out, yeah.
Oh, absolutely, without a question of a doubt. The proof's there. He's admitted it. It's not hearsay. We have the proof.
All right. Thank you all for being with us.